I promise you guys that in the next couple weeks, I'll be getting a new webcam. The one that I'm using right now, I got in an emergency when my other camera broke down. So I have to find a better camera. This one just isn't cutting it. Anyway, today's video is a interview for the YouTube user known as LakeShaman. And LakeShaman asked me 6 very interesting questions. And I would love to reply to him in this video. Here's his first question. What, if any, other religions did you practice or study before the occult and Satanism? When did you lose your faith in these other religious teachings? Well, LakeShaman, I've never really been anything but a Satanist. I was exposed to Christianity, but I wasn't forced to believe in Christian teachings. I had Christian friends, and I did go to a Christian private school, but at home, I was taught to accept that that was their beliefs, and that there was many different types of Christians, and not everyone had the same opinion on Jesus. And basically, I wasn't taught that Christianity was the final answer. So I never really had faith in it as a religion. I always kind of saw it as the way that people socially interacted with their God or something. I just never really understood Christianity from a religious point of view. So Satanism is really the only path that I come to accept. It's the only path that I feel comfortable with. On to the second question. How did you meet Mr. Satanas, or how did he meet you? This is a very interesting story. A couple of years ago, I was involved in the study of magic, and eventually, after learning from Franz Barden's initiation into hermetics, I got into working with the Goetia. And after working with some of the Goetic spirits for a while, I desired to find a spirit that could help me to learn about magic. But not just any kind of magic. I was interested in learning about direct magic, which is magic that is done without ritual. It might be kind of hard to explain unless you've experienced magic, but I've had experience with it. So anyway, I desired to have a teacher who could teach me about this type of magic. So I summoned a certain spirit from the Goetia, and that's what I asked for. I asked this demon to teach me or to guide me in my life towards the sources that would enable me to understand that type of magic. And the spirit did help me out. A couple weeks later, I met my husband, Bill, and we had an instant attraction. I knew that he had come into my life for a reason. Our first conversation was about magic. See, my husband has been into magic for over 30 years. And when I met him, he taught me all about his method of magic, which he calls mentalism, which is a type of magic that does not use ritual. Well, I believe that that's how we met. I believe that my ritual was a way of putting myself out into the universe and stating that I am ready to learn and I'm ready to move on and I'm ready to explore something new. And when I had opened my heart, that's how I met Bill. On to the next question. Number 3. Do you find yourself generally liking or generally disliking other Satanists in public or online? If you wish to elaborate, why or why not? Generally, I do not dislike other Satanists. I enjoy talking with other people. I have a great time discussing Satanism with Satanists from all different paths and styles. I'm not really particular about the type of Satanists that I like to hang out with. I've had interesting relations with LaVeyan Satanists and also with spiritual and theistic Satanists. I try not to draw a line and say that I prefer one side over the other because, in my view, both sides have their own benefits and their own ways of expressing Satanism, and to me, they are all Satanists. The next question. Excuse me. Have you ever been agnostic or atheist? By atheist, I do not mean rejection of God, but a lack of belief in any deity or entity outside of the material realm. Well, that's an interesting way to put it. I've always had a belief in an experience of the spiritual. Even when I was in a relationship that forced me to put my beliefs aside and hide the way that I was thinking and feeling about magic and spirituality, something inside me always made me feel that the spiritual is real and the spiritual is there. And by that time, I had had enough experiences to know that the spiritual realm is real. I've always been the type of person that would open myself to those experiences. So, to me, it's just a matter of perception. And it's something that I've always experienced, I've always felt. And so, no, I don't think I've ever been an atheist in the truest sense of the word. On to the next question. How do you think your life would be affected if you, by random chance, were not a Satanist? If you prefer an option, how would the lives of others, for example, your friends, your family, or your husband around you, be if you were not a Satanist? Well, this is a really interesting question. And actually, I have thought about this question before. But I realized that I don't believe that my life would have been very much different at all. I'm still a very independent and strong-willed person. I know what I want and I go after it. I'm very focused, I'm very artistic, I'm very creative. So there's been a lot of things in my life that have had nothing to do with Satanism that I have enjoyed. But I just don't think that my life would be much different at all. I'd still be me. I'd still be who I am. And I would still like that.